The new song is so beautiful. I keep going through my mind that this song didn't exist for 30 years when you stopped, you know, writing songs. And now it's here. And the idea of turning the lights back on in a relationship, I assume you're talking about a relationship, but maybe you're talking about your relationship to music. But have I waited too long? I could have been a better husband. I could have been a better boyfriend. I could have been a better parent, maybe even. But I neglected the role, and now I'm full of regret. And is it too late to turn the lights back on? Who are we talking about here? What's going on, Billy?
Well, I'm not going to get specific with it.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
You know this. There's a song. There's a singer, a French singer, Edith Piaf. She did a song called "Je ne regrette," which means
this song.
This is it. Big hit for her.
You knew this song.
Non, rien de rien. Non.
I went and looked up the lyrics to this thing, and she's saying, in life, I have no regrets, which is absurd.
Anybody who's really lived must have regrets. I mean, I owe 1,000 apologies to thousands of people.
Me too.
I have lots of regrets.
Yes, of course. How can you live a life with no regrets?
I don't believe that. So I wanted to respond to it.
With this song, Turn the Lights Back On, I know you hadn't written a song in a long time. I'm walking around on Long Island. This kid, young kid comes up to me. He says, hey, Howard Stern, you know Billy Joel, right? I go, of course I know Billy Joel. He's on my show, blah, blah, blah. Oh, he goes, I'm trying to get him to write a new song. I go, who the fuck are you? What do you mean? I mean, I'm trying too. Everyone's trying to get Billy to write a new song. But it was this dude, Freddy Wexler.
It was Freddy?
It was Freddy. How did he get you to write a new song? How did he get a hold of you?
He knew, his doctor knew my doctor. It was a very weird way. Somehow or another, got to me from my family doctor. He said, some guy wants to meet you. I said, okay. You know, he's a fan.
Yeah.
And that was pretty much it. I thought, I'll do something for the doctor. So meet the guy.
Right.
I meet this guy at a restaurant, and we're talking. And all of a sudden, I thought it was going to be a young kid. He was in his 30s. He's got his own family.
Yeah.
He lives in L.A. And he's a songwriter himself, and he's a record producer. And I recognize, wait a minute, this guy knows what he's talking about. It's not just a fan who likes the music. He knows how to write songs. He goes, why don't you want to write? I just don't want to. I put myself through the grist mill by doing this, and it's a torturous process because I have a high bar, and if it's not good enough, I'm not going to write it.
Right.
Because we really want to hear new music. That's fine. So you want to hear it, but I don't want to do it. And one way or the other, he got me to think about working together with him. He said, do you have any songs you haven't finished? And I said, yeah, sure. I got bits and pieces of things. I gave him a demo tape of my unfinished stuff.
Oh, so that was a good technique. In other words, it wasn't like a full-on committal. It's like, hey, here's some shit that I have laying around, the scraps, things, ideas, this kind of stuff.
Yeah, I don't want to finish them because for whatever reason, they're unfinished. And if you have a good idea, let me know.
Right.
So we did that for a while, and we tossed ideas around.
What did you send him that inspired the song? Like, did you send him something on the piano, like a little?
It's me and singing and a piece of a song idea.
What might that be? Like, what would that sound like?
Like that.
That's it.
That's it.
No lyric.
No lyrics. Barely a melody. There's a couple of things. It's like a hymn. Uh, kind of like an anthem or a hymn.
And so the reason you like this kid, Freddy Wexler, is you send him those, and he gets what you're doing there. He says, I hear something here. Maybe we could do this, that, the other thing.
He knew music. He knew how to play the piano. He knew how to write songs. So he said, let me try to come up with something in this idea that you have.
Right.
And we kicked it around for a while, and he came to me with the idea for Turn the Lights Back On.
Beautiful song, I mean.
Please open the door. Nothing
I love how your voice sounds on the record, too.
We've been here before, pacing these halls, trying to
My
talk
wife
over
broke into
the
tears
silence.
When she heard this. I mean, it's an emotional song. It gets you the chills immediately.
This is an interesting vocal for me.
Stuck in a frame,
I do a recording and I'm singing, and I go back into the control room and I hear a playback, and it's me singing, and I never like my own voice.
Yeah,
I'm always disappointed. The singer is not good. You know, somebody like Ray Charles or Rod Stewart should sing this. But I actually heard the vocal on this recording.
And you liked it.
And I didn't hate it.
Oh, that's progress.
I can't say I liked it. I was like, I don't hate that. That's one of the first times that's ever happened to me.
Who the fuck did you write this about?
I'm not telling you.
You have to tell me.
I can't.
It's a woman, right?
Partly, yes. There's a double meaning to it.
What do you mean?
Part of it is about a relationship, and part of it is about my own life. Like, is it too late to turn? I'm putting out a new record. Wait a minute. Do I get a second chance here?
Right.
That kind of thing.
I had the feeling this was about your own relationship to music.
Yes.
Wow.
Time can make you blind, but I see you now.
Maybe an album's coming out. That's what I'm getting from this.
In the darkness,
I don't know.
Did I wait?
Maybe.
Anything's possible. I'm now open to collaborating with other writers now.